Mother Media Research Institute recently published a study about breadwinning moms, which found that more than a quarter of all partnered working moms out-earn their spouses. With this change in the family dynamic comes more responsibility, and it can also bring added pressure. We're here with Carol Evans, founder of Working Mother Media, and also joining us is sex and relationship therapist Dr. Ian Kerner. Hi, you guys. Okay. Hi. All right. So, Carol, what are some of the biggest challenges women cited as a result of being the primary breadwinner?
Well, there's a lot of issues that they faced, but you know, I think one of the biggest ones is this issue of housework and parenting. And the we talked about that a little bit. They have lots of issues with not having enough burden relieved from them while they're bringing in the bacon. But on the other hand, there's another issue that they face, which is themselves. They do not feel like they ever have enough time for themselves, and their taking care of themselves falls last, even below their marriage. So they come in last, and they complain about that and feel that that is something that they don't know how to solve.
And Dr. Kerner, you treat couples in your practice. How often do you see issues arise when the mom is the primary breadwinner?
I see this issue a lot. You know, the main thing I see is that breadwinning moms feel much more guilt about being away from their kids than breadwinning dads do. So as a result, when a breadwinning mom comes home, she really wants to allocate any free time towards the kids. So that means in these relationships, there's often less date nights, less babysitters, less priority, less romance in the relationship, as opposed to when it's a more traditional breadwinning dad coming home.
Right. So I was going to say, dads can go on business trips and then spend the weekend playing golf and think nothing of it, right? And I think women are so wrapped with guilt.
I think there's an underlying sort of gender stereotype for the breadwinning mom in which she is happy and gets great self-esteem from being able to support her family, but feels a terrible tug and guilt around not being with the kids and being home with the kids.
You mentioned sex, right?
Yeah.
I know that you were recently quoted in a New York Times magazine article, and the title of it was, "Does a More Equal Marriage Mean Less Sex?" So how does this dynamic affect people's sex lives?
Well, one thing, as I just said, when mom is sort of out working all day, she doesn't really want to necessarily come home and immediately go out on a date night
or have anyone touch her for that matter.
Or necessarily have anyone touch her.
Except her child.
I think also, you know, sometimes the rules of your relationship don't necessarily apply to the rules of the bedroom. And it may completely work out that, yes, she appreciates that he's home with the kids more, or maybe picking up more of the housework at home, but that isn't necessarily sexy.
I thought that article was interesting because it suggested that when people are egalitarian and didn't have, there wasn't that much differentiation between them in terms of their gender roles, they became less attractive to each other.
Yeah, and you know, some of this has a lot to do with the men,
I was like, oh no!
That scared me too, that really scared me.
You know, the thing I've noticed, and sometimes when a woman is a breadwinning mom, for the dad, he may not feel that he's providing in the way that he should supposed to be. And so that can actually affect his self-esteem. So for some of these dads, especially the ones who don't have their own power, their own center, their own jobs, they may be kind of depressed and their libidos are dropping. So very often, contrary to the cliche, you may have a breadwinning mom who actually has a high libido, but a dad who's maybe more at home, who's a little more depressed, and his libido is diminished.
That's interesting. Meanwhile, Nicole and Peter Kerner are here, and they're from Scottsdale, Arizona. And Nicole, you're a financial advisor. You're the primary breadwinner. And can you relate to some of these issues that we're talking about?
Yes. All of them.
Really?
And I ended up writing a book that there's an infamous chapter 5 about how you just have to commit to making that time for an intimate relationship. You know, it's like fake it till you make it. Doesn't matter. It has to happen. And I'm surprised that when there's equality in a relationship that wouldn't be sexy to a woman, because I when Peter does the laundry or washes the floors, I'm like, oh, honey.
Come here. I want to rip your clothes off.
I am all over that.
Chore play.
Chore play. That's funny because this article pointed out that you would think like seeing a guy empty the dishwasher would be a turn on, but that it really actually wasn't, right? That's one of the points that article made.
Absolutely. That, again, what's sort of sexy in theory isn't necessarily sexually attractive.
Interesting.
But you
I don't
find
know, these
it
women
to
are
be.
Crazy.
Yeah. And Peter, I know you're a property manager for a development company, and you are the primary, I guess, person at home who manages your son's schedules. You do a lot of stuff for your kids. And obviously, you're modeling great behavior for them, Peter, because they're seeing you take such an active role in their lives and helping and supporting your wife, right, that hopefully they'll grow up and be just like you.
It's a blessing in disguise in that my father was a long-haul trucker and would be gone for days and sometimes weeks at a time, and never really had a lot of connectivity with him while I was, you know, toddler through my early teens. And I see it as a, you know, huge advantage to be spending the time with the boys that normally I never would.
And that's a silver lining that we didn't even mention. Yes. The fact that women out in the workforce earning more are allowing their husbands and the father of their children to have more, you know, the closer, more important relationships with their children. And that's a wonderful offshoot of this whole thing.
It really is. And moms being not home all the time forces dads to create their own relationship with their children without supervision from the mom. That's so key.
The only thing I want to add, though, is that we all want happy children, and happy children want happy parents, and happy parents are loving, connected, romantically entwined parents. So I would still say that you can't let your own relationship as a couple get lost in this sort of new mix of how you're doing things.
That's a good final piece of advice. Dr. Ian Curran, Carol Evans, thank you all so much.